All right, tonight I'm gonna do something a little different. I got this little wireless keyboard for my music PC. Wanted something small and compact, and with certain specific switches available. This is the Rye wireless keyboard and mouse combo, RKM709. Compatible with Windows, Fire TV, Mac OS, OS X, Android, and Smart TV. Rytec.com. I picked this up off Amazon. I want to say like $15. So I don't have super high hopes, but I think it'll do the job. We'll see. Apparently it takes four AAA batteries. Suitable for left and right hand operation. And avoid missing all the receivers placed in the back in the back of the keyboard. So, okay. Wireless keyboard mouse combo, auto connection through 2.4G wireless, USB 2.0 receiver as plug and play, and some multimedia keys. So let's just open it up and get at it. Oh, it's heavier than I thought it'd be. It's got a little bit of weight to it. Nice size. Let's get it out of this sleeve here. Oh yeah. I like that there's one of the things, no gloss blackness, all matte black. No gloss black. All right. We'll go over that a little bit more in a second. Let's look at the mouse. If I can get it out of here. Come on. Well, they couldn't help themselves. They had to put some gloss black somewhere. Kind of a different shaped little mouse. Very light. Of course, there's no batteries in it. Receiver inside. There we go. Typical clicky mouse. Oh, and it's got a DPI sensitivity button here in the middle. It looks like a some sort of LED indicator. Nice flat rubber scroll wheel. It also clicks. And then probably your standard page forward, page back buttons on the side. So pull that out. And then an on-off switch, of course, color-coded. There we go. Two AAA batteries go in there. And then here's the receiver they spoke of. Right there. Kind of hidden away. Which is nice for storage. There's nothing really new. A lot of companies do this. So we'll set that over there for now. Grab some batteries. All right, two AAA batteries. Snaps right in. All right. There's the indicator light. It's probably not gonna work because the receiver's not plugged in. Anyway, back to the keyboard here. Some sort of manual. This is exactly so far what I wanted. Perfect size. Little feet here. Nice rubber grommets to keep from sliding around if that were gonna be a thing. And then room for two more AAAs, which I have here. Whoops. Oh no, I had it the right way. There we go. Everything snaps in nicely. Yeah. Now, one of the reasons I picked this board is the size, the low profile. From the pictures, no gloss black. Anything you touch all the time, you don't want to be gloss black. On-off button on the front of the keyboard. Some of the wireless keyboards, it's on the back, which might not be a big deal, but this is going to be a keyboard and I carry around a lot and move a lot. I don't want to have to flip it over every time. I prefer just to have the on-off on the front, especially with kids around the house. I wish everything just had like a lock button disable on it, because they tend to, when you're doing something important, is when they always tend to bump your mouse or keyboard. And then it's got the PC on-off button here, which I can, I do, because my other keyboard already had that, and I have it configured just to put the computer to sleep and wake up, which is nice. And then volume up and down, since this is a music computer. I don't use the Windows volume too often, but it's just one of those things when you're doing stuff and listening to music. It's kind of nice just to have as many volume buttons around as possible. So if you're not within reach of the mouse or your remote for your stereo, or you know, within reach of the stereo, whatever, it's just another spot, you know, you can turn it down real quick if you have to, or up. And also when I'm messing with just doing different testing and stuff, and then the mute button too. So if I'm doing something and I'm near the keyboard, I can just reach over and hit mute. And so yeah, it's I didn't want one that had a whole bunch of extra media keys. I mean, I know it does have some function keys up here, but having these four buttons here and then the on-off switch is pretty much exactly what I was looking for, so that's great. And yeah, the rest of the keyboard doesn't get used a whole lot, maybe searching the library and stuff, but most of it is pretty straightforward work on a music computer. So yeah, it's just a basic keyboard. It's what I needed. Mouse feels pretty good in the hand, I guess. Oh, let's type on the keys here a little bit. Not too bad. Fairly tactile. Feels like about like a laptop, I guess. They're not necessarily squishy or rubbery, kind of like your typical generic membrane keyboard. Got a decent little click to them. They don't push too hard. Yeah. Excellent. Good little keyboard. All right. Let's go back to doing something else audio. Later.